This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Dear students, in this video lecture, first I will talk about relative density, especially vapor density. And after that, I will discuss the application of ideal gas equation with respect to mole concept. We all are aware of absolute density, right? What is the density? Mathematical definition of density is mass upon volume. Okay, now what is relative density? The relative density, if I say relative density of substance A with respect to substance B, relative density of A with respect to B, so it is actually ratio of two densities. Ratio of density of A, absolute density of A upon absolute density of B. So, ratio of the density of a substance A to the density of the substance B is known as relative density of A with respect to B. My point is clear? Now, on the basis of this B, if we take this B as the standard substance, if we take this B as the standard substance, or better I say, on the basis of this reference material, and the physical state of the substance, the relative density is divided into two categories. Relative density is divided into two categories. First is specific gravity. This relative density is for solids and liquids. And here the standard substance, or better I say, the reference material is H2O at 4 degrees Celsius. The second relative density is vapor density. Here the standard substance is H2 gas, and this relative density is for gases and vapors. Okay, now this vapor density is relative density with respect to H2, so I can write vapor density of substance A as density of substance A upon density of H2 according to the definition of the relative density. And now, what is density? Mass upon volume. So I can write this as mass of substance A upon volume of substance A. Obviously, this A is gas or vapor, upon mass of H2 gas upon volume of H2 gas. Okay, we all know that under the same conditions of temperature and pressure, one mole of all the gases occupies same volume. Or better I say, if we take same number of moles, the volume will be same under the same conditions of temperature and pressure. And you all are aware that at STP, standard temperature pressure, the volume occupied by one mole gas is how much? 22.7 liters. Okay, so if I take 1 mole of A, volume will be 22.7. If I take 1 mole of H2, volume will be 22.7. So, what can we write? Mass of A. If I take 1 mole of this, then it will become molar mass. Because mass of 1 mole of any gas is nothing but molar mass. So, I will write this as molar mass of A upon molar mass of H2. And what is the molar mass of H2? 2. My point is clear. So, this is the vapor density of A. And even if you do not take 1 mole, you take n number of moles, for that the volume occupied will be same. So volume will get cancelled. And that is why vapor density can also be defined as the ratio of mass of the given substance and mass of the H2 for the same volume. My point is clear. Now, with the help of this, we can write a generalized formula, that is vapor density is equal to molecular mass upon 2. Many of you must be aware of this formula. And students, please note that if the standard substance is changed, the formula will change. This vapor density formula we have got when we took H2 as the reference. For example, if an imaginary standard substance is given, let us say oxygen is taken as the standard substance. If I take oxygen as the standard substance, can you guess the change in the formula? You can see molar mass of H2 we have written here. So now the new formula of vapor density will be molecular mass upon, what is the molar mass of O2? 32. So this is the new formula as per the new standard substance. Students, now I will talk about ideal gas equation and its application with respect to mole concept. First of all, ideal gas equation. We will discuss this in detail in chapter gaseous state. But before that, I'll tell you that ideal gas equation is actually a relation. Relation between pressure, volume, number of moles and temperature for a gas, and the equation is PV is equal to nRT. Here P is the pressure exerted by the gas, V is volume occupied by the gas, N number of moles, and T here is temperature in Kelvin. And you should know that Kelvin temperature is degree Celsius plus 273.15. Now the most important part, R. R is gas constant. And depending upon the units of pressure, volume and temperature, the value of R is 0.0821 atm liter per mole per Kelvin. Here you can see the pressure must be in atmosphere, volume must be in liter, and the temperature must be in Kelvin if you want to use this value of R. Another value of R is 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin. Here we are using SI units of pressure, volume and temperature. Now, with the help of this PV is equal to nRT, I can write R is equal to PV upon NT. So, if we compare two gases, let us say gas 1 and gas 2, I can write R is equal to P1 V1 upon N1 T1. Since R is a constant, for the gas 2 also, it will be R P2 V2 upon N2 T2. That is why if I equate the two, for the two gases, I can write a very special relation. P1 V1 upon N1 T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon N2 T2. And with the help of this combined equation, I can derive many relations. For example, if the question says number of moles and temperature for the two gases are same, then what will be the relation? I can write P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Similarly, if question says volume and number of moles same for the two gases, then I can write P1 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon T2. If it says pressure and number of moles same, then I can write V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. So, different equations can be derived with the help of this standard combined relation. My point is clear. Now, I'll take few questions. With the help of questions, we will understand the applications of ideal gas equation. Here the question says, the weight of 1102 ml of a diatomic gas at 430 Kelvin temperature and 2 atmospheric pressure is 2 gram. Find out the vapor density of the gas, first question, and second, mass of one atom. Now, since temperature given, pressure given, volume given, you can easily think that this question is based upon the ideal gas equation. So, if I use the ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT and pressure is given as 2, volume is given as 1102, but it is ml, so I'll write in liter. So, divide this with 1000 is equal to number of moles is what? Number of moles is actually mass upon molar mass, right? Mass of the gas is given 2 gram, molar mass. It is a diatomic gas. Since it is diatomic gas, you can assume gas as A2. So, what will be the molar mass? 2A. My point is clear. So, I can write this as 2 upon molar mass of the diatomic gas into 0.0821 into temperature is given as 430. So, with the help of this, if I write molar mass, it will be 2 into 0.0821 into 430 into 1000 upon 2 into 1102. And if you solve, the molar mass comes as 32 gram. Since this molar mass is 32, vapor density is what? Molecular mass upon 2. Molecular mass is 32 upon 2. So, vapor density is 16. So, for the first part of the question, the answer is 16. The second part, it says mass of one atom. As we notice diatomic, that is why molar mass will be 2A. So, for single atom, the atomic mass can be found with the help of this. A comes as 16. The atomic mass is 16. So, what will be the mass of one atom? mass of one atom will be 16 into 1/12th mass of carbon 12 means 1 amu. So 16 into 1.66 into 10 raised to minus 24 gram. And if you solve, the value comes as 2.656 into 10 raised to minus 23 gram. Clear? Now, I will take another question here. Here the question says, find out the vapor density, first part, mass of one atom, second part, of a triatomic gas whose 1 gram occupies 172 ml volume at 630 Kelvin and 3 atmospheric pressure. Here the gas is triatomic, so you can assume A3. And I request you all to attempt this question on your own, and you can share your answer and solution with me at teacher@tisprepadda.com. Thank you. This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test, and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.